Hi, this is Johnny Bergen with another Chicago Blues lesson. This time, by request, going back to Jimmy Rogers. And there's two versions that I'm crazy about, Act Like You Love Me. The alternate take is a bit faster and has a lot more guitar in it. And the take that everybody knows is a little bit pulled back with just a real solid lump. And then there's a bit of a guitar solo during the first harp solo, like for the first go around before he sort of backs off. And anyway, that's really great. So the lead things that Jimmy Rogers plays in this is just priceless to me. And I've got a bit of an advantage listening to it because it seems like Dave Myers plays a lot of this stuff. I used to see Dave Myers so many times, and he played all these same things. Like, you can play that with your fingers, da 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 da, da. With your first finger kind of on the low, on the A string. It's kind of like a big Bill Brunzi kind of thing, isn't it? Then you need a real solid lump where you're hitting both strings. Especially on the real take, not the alternate take. The alternate take's more like, but the real take is. The love I got for you, I swear, and that's the B seventh with the low E string. Love I got for you, I swear, it's killing Paul me. Yeah, so this is that same turnaround that's in Country Boy, 5th fret and 4th fret on the A and G strings. Or then Jimmy Rogers might have done this. Buddy did this. Well, that's alright. That's alright. From the alternate tape. You might mid see this chord. Yeah, and then when you put that together with the muddy bass lines, and I'm going to come back and get the looper and do the muddy bass lines, you know. Sometimes you even hear that down, the up and down thing that's in like songs like Redheaded Woman by Leroy Foster and all that. Jimmy Rogers is more mellow. They really took the Big Bill Brunzi style and made it a little more rockin', kind of. With that, and with the drums going, you know, rather than just the, rather than with the thunk of the acoustic guitar, it's more of the rock and bass lines with the full band. So they really updated it in a cool way. So that's the kind of leads that Jimmy Rogers played on Act Like You Love Me, and it's really worth listening to both versions. I'm going to come back and do this real note for note with the bass lines and do it slow. But that's kind of an orientation of the two versions. All right, so I'm going to tighten up this video. I'm going to try to do the two Jimmy Rogers solos exactly in the alternate take, and then sort of the dueling solo that he does with Little Walter, where they're both really playing together like a counterpoint solo, you could call it. So I'm an F. So let's try the bass line. Okay. Sometimes you hear that clanging, you know. So one thing to really think about is the way he swings with this. It's just so nice. I'm just going to get in the groove. Get a little bit more of a trebly air tone. Now look at the way this swings. Let's see if I can catch this. One more time. It's the first solo. Okay, man. Back to the theme on the B string. Second one. I messed up the very last part of that second one. Right on, okay. Now I'm gonna go to G. Put the whole thing in G, and this is kind of what this is a synthesis kind of, and it's he's playing this while Little Walter's playing his solo. So go with this. Notice how this one is a little slower and more it's like two note boogies, not just the one note. You're hitting two notes at the same time. One more time. All right. I'll go over that kind of slow. It's real pretty. Something kind of like that. That was a little different, but pretty similar, right? Notice how there's a roll. Back of this. I love this. That's a 6th fret and 8th. That's the 8th and 9th fret. What is it? 9th and 10th fret? Because you're in G now. Back to this. That's just a raised 5 and a 5. open B string, and with the third, with the second finger on the low E string. Yeah. Make it bounce. So the second one's kind of a mellower synthesis of the first two from the alternate take. They must have done that one first, right? Then they tightened it up on the official release. So hope you enjoy this stuff. Try to make it swing. Try to make it bounce. Try to keep your thumb going. It's all the pretty music that's right in your E chord, this A seventh shape chord, this B seventh chord, and this chord. A little bit of this here. And that's basically it. You're in business. So if you have some comments about Jimmy Rogers, please leave them in the comments. I'd love to hear from you yet again. Back to Jimmy Rogers, a continual source of inspiration and an incredible guitar player. So stay in touch. Keep picking. See you next time.